So the next thing we need to do is maybe add a few buttons. Each one of these buttons we're going to show on the screen. Let's add those buttons to the scene or to the screen. Play button, give you the specific ID, give you the text value, we can put it somewhere on the screen, a specific position, X offset 0, Y offset, let's make it 60, 80 positive Y. ID. Button options. You're going to center this in the middle of the screen, and then the credits button. Center at minus 80 offset. Save. Let's see it run. Oh, and there we have three of our buttons. Next, let's add some sort of way to handle clicks. We're going to add a touch button listener, and luckily we have Galago have its own implementation of a touch button listener called the touch button adapter. If you used to swing, you know what I'm talking about. And then we insert code, override, do touch up. After that, we need to check, is this screen active? Sorry guys. So is active. The screen is active. We can do the following. We can say show screen play. The play screen doesn't exist yet, so let's go and create it. I'm going to create a new class called play screen. Make this one extend abstract screen again. and then implement the methods. Set a label, say label heading new label. I am the hello from play screen. So let's test. Okay, let's click on play. Oh, screen play does not exist. Oh, we need to add it to the screen manager. So in the main application, where we initialize the screens, we say screen manager dot load screen. Give it the play screen. Okay. This should do the trick. Oh, there we have our play screen. And if you should click on back, it keeps flow of which screen was the previous one. So you can just click escape and it will go back. Now we can do the rest of the buttons and screens. Thanks for watching this tutorial.